I'm Juan Chef from Outdoors and Lawn Countries, and in this video we're going to have a look at the steel brush cutter, the FS461CEM. The engine has a displacement of 45.6 cubic centimeters and an engine power of 2.2 kilowatts or 3.0 horsepower. The 461 comes with a 4-point anti-vibration system that dampens the vibrations from the engine and drivetrain towards the user. Now this brush cutter comes with either the AutoCut 46-2 with the wires for mowing the grass or for some heavier stuff, the triangular knife. Also, this harness is included in the package where you can connect your brush cutter to for comfortable wearing. So in this video, we're going to unbox, install, test and review this strong steel brush cutter with the AutoCut 46-2 device running onto it. Now I had a hand mower and I hit a rock with it, and as a result my crankshaft was bent. So I was complaining about that on my steel dealer, and then he mentioned, well, that's your own fault because you're using your hand mower as a brush cutter and you shouldn't do that. So he explained to me the differences, and he convinced me that for the work that I'm doing, I shouldn't use a hand mower, but something else. Also, some other people told me already in the past that I shouldn't use a hand mower like that. That yeah, sometimes a little bit stubborn, and then things need to go wrong before you learn the hard way. But at least now we have a brush cutter, the FS461 from Steel. Let's open up the box, see what's inside, assemble it, and then do some first tests. This is a triangular blade for the rougher universal harness. The metal. Now Steel also added a safety goggle. Now I think that's a good thing. You have to be careful with your eyes and of course with those fast turning knives and wire. It's always wise to use safety goggles as well as hearing protection, by the way, because they make quite a sound. The tools. Now, since I will not only use this for brush cutting, but also for mowing grasses at difficult places, because that's where it went wrong with the hand mower. And yeah, there will be some rocks or some other materials, or also close to a tree. And that's also why I bought this head. It's the AutoCut, where you can use a wire to cut the grass. And also some extra wire. This is some stronger wire than normal, because it will be some rough material that I'm intending to mow. It's a 2.7 millimeter wire. Now let's put it on and see how well it does. So we're going to both use it as brush cutter as for the grass mowing. So let's mount the steering bar. So here you see the handlebar and this little spring that comes along with it should be mounted in here and then put on the system. So according to the manual, the distance from the center of the mounting bracket towards the handlebar should be 16 centimeters. Well, that's exactly the case. So that's also how it came out of the box. But it's always good to check it. So the next step is now to mount the throttle. I see on the box that the cable should go like this underneath. Maybe I need to release it a little bit. So now let's turn it around and put on the mowing head. So here you see the principle of the drive mechanism. This one has a bearing onto the top one, and I can put it like this. And with the locking pin, you can put in one of those holes, and then it will fixate the axis. So let's now put on the head. That's it, remove locking pin. So
mowing it has been mounted.
So the system comes with two detector guards, a large one for this grass cutter and a small one for the triangular blade that we will mount later. So let's first mount this one. It has Torx screws, but also very large normal screwdriver screws. So let's put it up. I think I should have mounted the guard before I mount the head, so I think I have to remove the head again. Okay. And the protector guards have screws that cannot fall out. That's nice, so you never lose them. So this system comes with an auto elongation. That means that when you push the button while doing the actual work, the centrifugal force will pull on the wires and they will extend. And when they become too long, they will be cut off by this element over here. So that won't be a problem. And what I also read in the manual is to keep mowing lines in a water bath between 12 hours and 24 hours before use to increase their useful life. Okay, didn't know that. So let's also have a look at the harness. So this hook should be about one width of a hand below the hip. So that's about it, I think. So even though this is a four-stroke engine, you need to put in two-stroke gasoline. So that means a mixture of gasoline and a little bit of oil. Well, if you have a chainsaw, you already have it. So I will put my chainsaw gasoline in. So it's now filled up, everything is mounted. It's time to do the actual testing. So let's go outside and let's see how well it mows the grass. This is throttle. So you see, you have to be careful because even with the wire, you still are cutting small pieces of wood. System to increase the length of the wire works very well, but if you do it on the grass, you get this ugly trimble sound. And it's longer, but it works great. So let's clean it a little. So let's also do a weight measurement. The Steinberg scale has an accuracy and a resolution of 4.1 kilo. So the FS461 with the grass cutting head weighs 10.5 kilos. A few days ago I used a brush cutter at a friend's place where the grass was really, really tall. It was a very large area as well. And as a result, the original wire broke a lot. And then I had to take the outer cut apart and I'll show you. It's done quite easy. Now when the wire breaks and it doesn't come out anymore on one side or sometimes even on both sides, no problem at all. Just push the buttons of the lid at both opposite sides and it will pop off. You can then take the wire, push it back through the hole and place the lid back. And you're good to go. And that is why for in those fields with those thicker materials and those higher stuff, I can really recommend to use a stronger wire. This is a 2.7 millimeter wire from steel. There are also even thicker diameters as well. that really improve the mowing force, the mowing power. You can really feel it also when you use it, but also it doesn't break that often anymore. Now, steel includes the safety goggle to protect your eyes, which is a great thing and very important. And to be honest, I can really recommend to use even more protection. I use my chain safety helmet for that. It has hearing protection, it has eye protection, and also the face mesh. Because as you can see, there are still particles on it that otherwise hit you in the face. In the beginning, using it without the safety helmet, but also only with hearing protection and safety goggle, I really got hit by particles in the face. It's a very strong device, and especially with the higher materials, even with the cover, you sometimes get hit by small particles, which isn't nice. And when I was doing the job at my friend's house, there was some sharp, hard, small object lying there. I don't even know what it was, but it hit me in the chest, didn't even start bleeding. So I was really glad that I wore my safety helmet with the mesh at that time, because that's not something that you would like to have in your face. So be prepared. And the harness is very comfortable and easy to connect your device onto. And to prevent those loose ends from flapping around, I like to fold them up and to push them in here, so you don't get all these loose ends flapping around while working. Like this, and you can do that also at the bottom side. Now, connecting your device is then easy, so you can then hook up the machine in any one of those holes, whichever one gives you the most comfort. Use the machine, and then when you are ready, you just put your thumb on the orange part and you can take it off very easily. So we now have a cold system. So the first thing we do is put the switch in the start position. Push the manual fuel pump 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Put on your hearing protection. Start the engine. I let it run for a couple of seconds to let it get warm. And then put on eye protection as well as face protection. Stop it, press this button, then the engine stops. So I used already for quite a long time, especially at my friend's house, which was a very large area that we had to clean. The harness is very comfortable for that. My recommendation is put it a little bit up in the front at first, because it will wear down at the end. But it was very comfortable wearing it with the safety helmet, with my gloves. I really liked the work. It's a strong system, no problem at all to go through the very high grasses and other weeds and things like that. Also even small trees it will take out, no problem. The strong wire you can really feel going easier through all those type of materials. And to be honest, especially when you've been working for a long time, this comfort system, it really reduces the vibration. So of course I didn't work with one with vibration, so difficult to compare, but I didn't have any problems at all with my hands or something like that. They really felt great. So I think it's a very nice device. I have a lot of places still to clean, so a lot of work for me to do. I didn't yet test the triangular brush cutting knife. That's something that I still need to do, and I will update you on that in another video. So I want to thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I see you next time.